Hi everyone, in this video we'll go through problems related to time and work, time and distance and mixtures related problems. We'll work out 3-marker problems in this particular video. Before we get into the problems, right, we need to understand what is direct proportional and what is inversely proportional. Direct proportional means if one quantity increases, the other quantity also increases. For example, time taken to complete a piece of work increases if the work increases, right? If the amount of work increases, time taken to complete the piece of work also increases. Similarly, if the amount of work reduces, then the time taken to complete that work also will reduce. So basically, here there are two quantities. One is time and one is amount of work. So as the amount of work increases, time increases. As the amount of work decreases, time also decreases. So what this means is, if one quantity increases, the other quantity also increases. If one quantity decreases, the other quantity also decreases. So this is called as directly proportional. What is inversely proportional? Inversely proportional is if one quantity increases, the other quantity decreases, right? If one quantity decreases, the other quantity increases, right? So there is a reverse. One increases, the other decreases. So let's take an example. Say, as the speed increases of the vehicle, time taken to reach the destination will reduce. Speed increases, time taken will reduce, right? If speed decreases, then time taken to travel or reach the certain destination will increase. So this is an example of inversely proportional. Similarly, if you increase the number of workers, right? If you increase the number of workers, then obviously the time taken to complete the work will reduce, because if you increase number of workers, more work will be done, and therefore the time taken to complete that entire work will reduce. So this is an inversely proportional. Here number of workers is increasing and time taken is decreasing. If number of workers is reduced, then time taken will increase. So this is an example of inversely proportional case. Now let's take few 3-marker problems. If rupees 150 maintains a family of 4 persons for 30 days, how long will rupees 600 maintain a family of 6 persons? This means that to maintain a family of 4 persons for 30 days, 150 rupees is needed. Now, if you have 600 rupees and if you have to maintain a family of 6 persons, then so how many days can you maintain the family? We'll have to find the number of days here. So how will we have to write? We'll have to first identify the quantities. Quantities means different parameters in this question. So different parameters are, one is money, one is number of people in the family, and the other one is number of days, right? So we will write persons, money and days, number of days. Now for 150 rupees is the money, 4 persons and 30 days, right? Now second ratio would be 600 rupees, family of 6 persons, how long, that is number of days. We'll have to find number of days for rupees 600 for a family of 6 persons. So we'll call this as X. Let's assume that number of days needed is X, right? Now we will have to take this particular ratio with persons and with money separately. So we'll take persons versus days, money versus days. So basically we need to find days, right? So we'll have to take persons with days and money with days. So persons versus days. Let's take person versus days. First, we need to find out if it's directly proportional or inversely proportional. This is very important, right? We first need to find the type of proportion it is. So, 4 persons can be maintained for 30 days. You can maintain 4 persons for 30 days. Now, if I increase the number of persons to 6 persons, obviously, I'll not be able to maintain 6 persons for 30 days because I can maintain only 4 persons for 30 days. Now, if I increase the number of persons, then the number of days will come down. I'll not be able to maintain 6 persons for 30 days. It will be lesser. So now here what's happening? Persons have increased. If persons increase, days will come down. Therefore, it is inversely proportional, because as the persons increase, the number of days that you can maintain those persons will come down, will reduce. So it is inversely proportional. Let's write the proportion. Normally it is 4:6. 4:6 is to equal to 30:x. You take it in this direction. Right? You take 4:6 is equal to 30:x. This is how you take it. Right? Now, since it is inversely proportional, you will have to swap this. You will have to swap this. Instead of 4 is to 6, it will become 6 is to 4 is equal to 30 is to x. So this unit, this quantity, this ratio will get reversed. So it will be 6 is to 4 is equal to 30 is to x. Now we'll go to, we finished persons versus days. Let's go to money versus days. Money versus days. I have 150 rupees. I can manage 30 days. Now I have 600 rupees. So if I have more money, obviously I can manage for more number of days. If I have less money, I'll be able to manage for less number of days. Basically, this is directly proportional. Because if money increases, days will increase. Money decreases, days will decrease. Therefore, this particular ratio, money versus days, is directly proportional. Now, how will you write? You will have to write it as 150 is to 600. 150 is to 600 is equal to 30 is to x. Right? Directly proportional. So now you have two proportions here. Right? We have two proportions. Now, we'll have to find this value of x. Right? To find this value of x, what we have to do is, we will have to take product of means is equal to product of extremes. What are the means? These second terms are means. Second ratio terms are means. The extremes, what are there on the ends? Extremes. What are there in the ends are called as extremes. So we have 6x, 150x. All of these are in the ends. What are means? Those that are in the center. 4, 30, 600, 30. These are in the center. Now we will have to take product of means is equal to product of extremes. So product of means, what are the means that we have? This is the means. Right? These are the means that we have. So we'll take the product of the means. That is 4 into 600 here. 4 into 600 into 30. Right? We don't have to take 30 into 30. Take only once. Into 30. This is equal to product of extremes. What is product of extremes? These are the extremes. The last values. Right? The last values. First and fourth. Right? First and fourth proportions are the extremes. So, it will be, you have to multiply 6 into 150. 6 into 150 into x. 6 into 150 into x is equal to product of means. Now, we'll find the value of x. X is equal to, so take these values to the right hand side. So it will become divide by 6 into 150. We'll get the value of x as 80 days. So we need 80 days to maintain family of 6 persons with rupees 600. Now let's go to another problem. Here, 5 carpenters can earn rupees 540 in 6 days, working 9 hours per day. How much will 8 carpenters earn in 12 days, working 6 hours a day? So we'll first identify the quantities or the parameters. First parameter is carpenters, then days, money, hours, right? So we have 4 parameters: carpenters, days, money and hours. Now we'll start putting the proportion values. 5 carpenters, 540 rupees, 6 days, 9 hours. So first proportion is done. How much will 8 carpenters earn in 12 days, 6 hours? How much will 8 carpenters earn? Earn means we need to find the money. We need to find the amount. So, let's assume that money earned is x. Right? Money earned is x. Let's assume that. So, we'll have to find this value of x. Right? So, each of these quantities or parameters, you'll have to find the ratio with money. So, carpenters versus money. Days versus money. Hours versus money. So, now, we'll first take carpenters versus money. You can take any order, right? You can take carpenters first or days first or hours first, right? So we'll take carpenters versus money. Carpenter versus money. Let's find out if it's directly proportional or inversely proportional. 5 carpenters earn 540 rupees. If there are 8 carpenters, how much money they will earn? Obviously, it will be more, right? The total money for 8 carpenters is going to be more because the number of carpenters have increased. So you have to pay them more. The total money spent on these 8 carpenters will be more. So it's directly proportional. If the carpenters decrease, if you have 3 carpenters, then the money will also come down. Therefore, it's directly proportional. It's directly proportional. Right? Now, so for directly proportional, how do we have to write? We'll have to write 5 is to 8. 5 is to 8 is equal to 540 is to x. Now we'll go to next one, days versus money. Days versus money. 6 days, you earn 540. Working for 6 days, 540 is being earned. If you work for 12 days, obviously the amount of money will be more, right? So this is again directly proportional. So how will you write? 6 is to 12, that is this one, 6 is to 12 is equal to 540 is to x, is equal to 540 is to x. Now we'll go with hours versus money. If you work for 9 hours a day, you will earn 540 rupees. If you earn for 6 hours a day, you will earn less, right? So in this case also it's directly proportional, because the more you work, the more money you will get. The lesser number of hours you work, lesser money you will get. So it is directly proportional, because one increases, the other one increases. One decreases, the other also decreases. Therefore, it is direct. And for direct, what we have to do? 9 is to 6, right? 9 is to 6 is equal to 540 is to x. So we have arrived with three proportions. Now we'll have to use this. Product of means is equal to product of extremes, right? Now, what are the means here? Means are all the second values, right? These are means, correct? These are means, right? Now, let's write the means. Means is equal to 8 into 12 into 6 into 540. These are means, is equal to product of extremes. These are extremes. This, the last fourth proportional, first and fourth proportional, the corner, the last terms are the extremes. So what will it be? It will be 5 into 6 into 9 into x. 5 into 6 into 9 into x. We don't have to repeat this x multiple times, just once. Similarly, we don't have to repeat 540 multiple times, just once. Okay. Now we'll find out the value of x. X is equal to, we'll get 8 into 12 into 6 into 540 divided by, let's get all of this to the other side. We get 5 into 6 into 9, which is nothing but rupees 1152. The money earned by 8 carpenters in 12 days by working 6 hours per day is X, and that X is nothing but 1152 rupees. Let's take this particular example. A mixture contains milk and water in the ratio 6 is to 1. On adding 5 liters of water, the ratio of milk and water becomes 7 is to 2. Find the quantity of milk in the original mixture. Here, there is a mixture of milk and water, and the ratio of milk and water is 6 is to 1. That is, there is 6 portions of milk and 1 portion of water. Say for example, there could be 6 liters of milk and 1 liter of water, right? It is just the ratio. We don't know the actual quantity of milk and we don't know the actual quantity of water, but there is only the ratio, which could be, for example, it could be 6 liters of milk and 1 liter of water, or it could be 12 liters of milk and 2 liters of water, or it could be 18 liters of milk and 3 liters of water. The ratio is 6 is to 1. Now, on adding 5 liters of water to this particular mixture, you add 5 liters of water, the ratio will change to 7 is to 2. First, we'll write ratio for milk is to water. Milk is to water is 6 is to 1. Now, you add 5 liters of water. So, let's assume that quantity of milk is X and quantity of water is Y, which means milk is to water will be X is to Y, because we are assuming milk quantity is X and water quantity is Y. So X is to Y is 6 is to 1. Now, I add 5 liters of water. 5 liters of water. What is water? Water is Y. We are denoting quantity of water as Y. So to this Y quantity, we are adding 5 liters, right? So now X is to Y plus 5, because we are adding 5 liters. Then the ratio becomes 7 is to 2. 7 is to 2. After adding 5 liters of water, that is Y, right? Quantity of water is Y, and we are adding 5 liters to this water. So it will be Y plus 5. So now the ratio would be 7 is to 2. We'll have to write this in the form of equations, because ultimately we have to find this value of X. So let's write the equations. Now X is to Y is equal to 6 is to 1. We can write this like this. We can write it as X by Y is equal to 6 by 1. Now we'll write it as equation, right? This is nothing but X into 1 is equal to 6 into Y. We'll take Y on the other side. So it'll be X is equal to 6Y. X is equal to 6Y. So let's call this as equation 1. Now we'll go to this equation 2, that is ratio, second ratio. X is to Y plus 5 is equal to 7 is to 2, which is nothing but X by Y plus 5 is equal to 7 by 2. We can write this in this form also, right? So now I just want to find value of x. So what I'll do, I'll move this here. I'll move this entire denominator to the other side. So y plus 5 into 7. So it becomes 7y plus 7 into 5, which is 35. So x will be 7y plus 35 by 2. I'll take 2 this side. So it'll become 2x is equal to 7y plus 35. Let's call this as equation number 2. I have to resolve these equations so that I can find the value of x, right? So what I'll do, solve it in such a way that x and x will get cancelled or y and y will get cancelled. We have x is equal to 6y and 2x is equal to 7y plus 35. So these are the equations that we have. Now we'll have to find the value of x and y, right? We need x. To find the value of x or y, we need to ensure that one of them will get cancelled. Either x will get cancelled or y will get cancelled. So what we can do is, we can multiply this entire equation by 2, right? If I multiply this entire equation by 2, then this will become 2x. And then I can subtract it with this equation. So it will become 2x is equal to 12y. Then I subtract it with this one. 2x is equal to 7y plus 35, right? Now I'll subtract this entire equation. Now what will happen? 2x and 2x will get cancelled because it's plus 2x and minus 2x. It will get cancelled. The reason I'm subtracting is so that 2x and 2x will get cancelled. So I'll get 12 minus 7y, which is 5y minus 35. And this will get cancelled, so it will become 0. Now I can find the value of y, right? So 5y minus 35 is 0. From this, I will get y value. Y is 7, right? Now that I have the value of y, I can substitute this value of y in any of these equations. This is the equation 2. This is equation 1, right? We can substitute the value of y in any one of these equations, right? Let's substitute in equation 1. In this equation, we'll substitute the value of y. So x is equal to 6y, y is equal to 7. So 6 into 7 is 42 liters. Therefore, x is 42 liters. So the quantity of milk is actually 42 liters. Because we had assumed the quantity of milk is x. So quantity of milk is 42 liters.
With this, we've come to the end of this particular topic. Thanks for watching. Hope this video was useful.